The broadcast is now starting. All attendees are in listen-only mode.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the last webinar from our BIM workflow week through the eyes of the structural engineer. My name is Adriana Gherlan, and I will present this last webinar. The theme of today's presentation is related to BIM workflow for steel projects, meaning the integration between advanced design, the design platform, and advanced steel, the detailing platform. Let's have a view of the today's agenda. We will do a short description of the software we are using for this workflow, the demonstration of the BIM workflow, and some conclusions. The first software we are using in this presentation, it's the design platform, Advanced Design, and we will have a zoom on the steel design capabilities of Advanced Design. So for the steel design, we can do lateral torsional buckling, advanced checks for any kind of section, thanks to an advanced method based on 7 DOF elements with second order warping analysis. We can do steel member optimization based on the flexion or stability working ratio. We have detailed and comprehensive steel design reports, meaning that we include in these reports all the intermediate formulas and results. We have an integrated steel connection design. So in advanced design, we can design 2D connections, but also 3D connections. Also, Advanced Design has a complete library for floors and roof, which is basically speeding you up your modeling with an integrated library of steel structural members, including the steel decks. And it's offering a BIM workflow with Advanced Steel and Revit, having a bidirectional link between Advanced Design and Autodesk softwares. Next is the detailing platform, and we are talking about Advanced Steel. It's a 3D modeling software for steel detailing, fabrication, and construction, offering to structural engineers and detailers parametric structural elements, intelligent steel connections, automatic tools for miscellaneous steel work, steel detailing and fabrication data, and BIM interoperability. The last software that we'll use in this BIM workflow, it's the PowerPack for Advanced Steel. Advanced PowerPack, in fact, it's a plugin which is accelerating the design process inside Autodesk softwares. It has different flavors. It's available for Advanced Steel, for Revit, for Inventor, and for Vault. Now I will try to list a few features of the PowerPack for Advanced Steel. One of them is the platform cover creator, which is automatically helps you to create gratings or plate covers based on what elements you are selecting. We can export IGS and STEP to IGS and STEP format. So either you can export the entire model or selected parts. We have the possibility to edit and update similar joints in a single command using the multi-edit joint. We have a library of 29 connections. The special part manager allows you to manage and assemble different special parts, which can be used in specific joints based on the user input, of course. A stair module, straight or balanced, multi-flights, customizable landings and treads, and more options in the stair module. And the railing module also, we have multiple type of railings with possibilities to define them starting from points, from lines or beams. We have inside the split mechanism, special parts, and more and more. And let's not forget about the GT6 file transfer format, which is available and is making the link between Advanced Steel and Advanced Design. Now let's go to the demo, the BIM workflow with Advanced Steel from Advanced Design. We will start the modeling in advanced steel. So here it's a steel frame, and beside the steel frame I have added also some connections between the elements, some base plates, assuming that in the BIM process the modeling in advanced steel can be more advanced when you decide to go to the design area. We are exporting the model using the GTCX file format. The command is available on the PowerPack for advanced steel. And don't forget after the export to save the information, because all the information about the GTCX file is saved inside the model. Then we go in advanced design and we are importing directly from the starting page the model. After the import is done, we can see that the connection that I placed in the advanced steel model are arriving also in advanced design. We see here the base plates that were transferred. And if we turn up the view, we'll see also the hunches on the putting columns and rafters, and also the apex connections that were placed in the model from advanced steel. Now we go further in advanced design to have the preparation of the model for designing, in fact, and we are starting to setting up the geometrical and design properties for the rafter. We can create super elements in advanced design. And also using the properties templates, we can propagate the information from just one element. So in this case, I will configure just one rafter. I will set up the geometrical properties and also the design properties for only one element. And after everything is set up, the deflection, the buckling, the lateral torsional buckling, I will save all this information in one template, property template, and I will propagate the information for all the other rafter in the structures. It's very easy and very fast to use the properties template. So also the lateral torsional buckling can be done using the intermediate restraints graphically on your view, and automatically these are saved inside the property of the element. And once the template is saved, it will go to the next, to all the rafters inside the structure. As you can see now, I'm loading a property template and all the properties of the elements. I will check in a second. For the designing, we can see here that are exactly like the rafter that I configured previously. So in one shot, I propagated the information for all the rafter. We will go the same with the purlins. And but for the purlins and the columns, I will use the information for the design templates. In fact, I will not use the property templates because I want just to propagate the information for the design properties for all the purlins in one shot. So I will load the design template, and I will configure this design template, and then I just using the option to load the design template, I will just put this template for all the purlins, and do the same, of course, for columns. After you finish to create set up the properties of all the elements, we can go further, and we are putting the load areas, which are helping us to do a repartition of the loads on our structure. You can do this either manually or by selecting selection. Once the loads area are created, we can set up the properties of this loads area in order to define the direction how the loads are will be redirected in the structure. So what elements will take the loads, and of course, for example, for the interior one, we can set up a mechanical behavior in this case because it's not loaded with snow or wind, so it's behaving like slab. After we are setting everything for loads area, we can define then the loads. In fact, we are creating some case low case families in one shot to multiple cases, and very easy for the climatic loads. You can use the one key feature of advanced design, which is the climatic generator. So with one just one click, we have loads on the entire structure, and it's very fast and easy. No problem to generate these loads in one shot. The same is available also for wind. So all the climatic loads are generated in one shot. We go with the combinations. And practically our model is ready for calculation. After we do the FEM calculation, the steel calculation, we can see some displacements, we can see some, we can check the steel design reports after that, we can see also the forces, the reactions on, and also the moments. So we can check some results very fast. But the target in this webinar is to show you how we can transfer and how we can synchronize the changes that you are doing in advanced design with your model in advanced steel. So we will focus on the optimization of the sections. In this case, we can see that we have to optimize some rafters and some purlins. We will open the shape sheet and also the optimization table, and we can see where is the problem and if we are selecting the other one, we can check the same problem in the shape sheet. And opening the optimization table, we can see that we can optimize by element, by section, by design template, by name, by per system, and so on. Advanced design is proposing some sections. We can accept those proposition, or we can decide on our own what we can choose. For the purlins in this case. So in my presentation, basically I'm optimizing the those two lines of purlins. I know that the calculation it's not updated because I already changed many times the section. So each time, basically after you do update of the section, you have to recalculate. And after you are doing this optimization, until you get the sections that you need for your model. Going further, we can check a little bit the reaction on the supports. And because you know that I already placed some connection inside the model, I will try to design. In fact, I will design two connections, and you see here that these connections are grouped. So for example, for the brace plate, even if I had 8 connections inside the inside my module, or I don't remember exactly, I think 10 more, is taking the most the one that is most solicited, and it's basically I'm designing one connection for all the supports which are similar. So using the steel connection, the advanced design steel connection module inside advanced design, we can design very easy connections. We are preparing the geometry, the loads are coming from advanced design. We are running the calculation and we can easily design and verify these connections. Why we are doing this here? Because we can save the detailing reports. These reports, we can reuse them basically to detail, create our connection inside Advanced Steel. So even if you you created your connections from the beginning of this beam process in Advanced Steel, you imported them in Advanced Design, you design them here, and using the information from the design report, you can adjust your connection in Advanced Steel. So this is the second connection that I'm designing. The principle is the same. I grouped the connections for the apex in only one group. And here, basically, I'm designing only the most affected one, let's say, and the most solicited one. And it's propagating the information for all the four apex connections in my model. The principle is the same. We are creating the geometry. After that, of course, the loads are coming from advanced design. So the moments, the forces inside the internal forces. After we are calculating the connection, we are saving it. And of course, we are having a result. This result can be used and have it on a detailing report. And with that the report, we can go in advanced steel. Now, after we are finishing the designing in advanced design, we are exporting this model in a GTCX file format for a synchronization in advanced steel. So using the export command, we are saving the GTCX file back to advanced steel. Okay, and as you saw, I had an option to export only elements on for advanced steel, and now we are back in advanced steel. So in the new version, in the coming version 2022, the power pack will have a new mechanism, the synchronization mechanism. So we are loading this new mechanism. And inside this dialog, I can load the GT6 file that I exported from Advanced Design. And you will see that all the information that I had in Advanced Design is listed here. And basically, we are synchronizing the model that we optimized in Advanced Design with the model in Advanced Steel. This dialog is very intuitive and it has a lot of information for you. It's allowing you to filter, to manage each parameter independently. You can take decision different for each parameter of the same object. So this is very important. You can basically control any detail of your synchronization. So if we are getting, for example, a view of this beam, we are noticing that here the material is changed. And why? In advanced steel, we have the material with S355RGR. And in the GTC, it means in advanced design, we had it like S355. So this is a difference that is noticed by this synchronization mechanism and is listed here. We can take a decision and we can see all the information about the object. It's a beam type. What is the status? What kind of element it's in the model? It's a purlin. And what are the changes attributes? In this case, is the material. So we can filter, for example, to search all the purlins inside the this dialog, inside the file, and we can take a decision for all of them in one shot, for example, if we want. In this case, I will try to synchronize only the beams that the purlins that I change in the optimization process. So you remember that I optimized two lines of purlins in the middle of the frame, exactly those two. So those two lines. So I can go one by one. And for example, I don't care about the material because I want to keep the material inside advanced design to be as 355, and in advanced steel I want it to be keep it the same. So if I want to keep this information, I can keep it or I can ignore it. It means that next time I will not have it inside this dialogue. And for the type, I choose to accept what the synchronization dialog is proposing me. So I can see that in the host application in advanced steel, I had 140 and I want 180. This can be done in one shot for all the elements or one by one. It depends on what kind of decision you want to take. So if you want to change also the material, you can just select all of them and you can just take a decision in one shot for all the parameters and for all the elements in your list. So I can do the same for all of them. So once I'm accepting from the parameters level, because this is like it's behaving like a tree, as you can see. So once the parent it has a decision, it is spreading this decision on the child. So I can select multiple lines and take in one shot the decision for all of them, and I can apply these changes for the moment. So it's not necessarily close the dialogue and reload it again and so on. I can do the synchronization step by step. One by one, I'm taking my time to take the decision I want to make, and so on. I don't have to rush everything in one shot. So after we are clearing the filters, because these are filters which are allowing you to easily filter the information inside the dialogue due to the amount of information, so it's easy to manage. For example, we can see here I have some deleted information. It means that this deleted information, in fact, are the information about the connections I had in advanced design. For the moment in the synchronization, we don't have a desynchronization of the connections, but we are having the information here. So it means that it's not matching the updated connection that I did. And my intention is not to delete this plate inside advanced steel. I want to keep them because I have the reports from advanced design. So I already designed my connection in advanced design. I can just come here and very quickly update the library, the connection itself. So I can apply the geometry that I already checked in advanced design very fast using the advanced steel joint mechanism, of course, and but already I have this info checked. So once applied, I no longer have to go back and design it because it's already done. So I choose to delete, to ignore all the deleted objects. I don't want to see them anymore for the moment. So I ignore them. So you can see that I don't have any more this information here in the dialog. Now if we are remembering, I did a optimization for the rafters, so we can see here that we have some rafters which are one of them is new, and it's because of the super element information. One of them is having a change of material and the geometry, so we can check the geometry of the object, if it's moving, if it's it's changing the position inside the structure. We can check that, and if we want to accept it, we can accept it. If not, we can ignore it. If not, we can just keep it like that. And until we take a decision. So for example, for this rafter, I see that I changed the section in from IP 300 to IP 360. So I'm accepting or ignoring, it depends on what you are wanting to do. The idea is that once you ignore a change, that change will not longer be available for in your dialogue. It means that you don't care about that change, and it in fact is not changing the information in your model. It's you are ignoring that change, and so your model in advanced still is the same. So in this case, because I ignored the material change, the material in advanced still will be the same. The material in advanced design, the naming, in fact, it will be the same in advanced design, and it will be the same in advanced still. I will not change it. It will be the difference that I have two letters at the end. If I accept the change, it means that advanced the synchronization mechanism, it will update the information about that object. So in this case, the rafter will be bigger. So I can do that for each element one by one. It's up to you how you manage it. It has a full flexibility for you, for a user. You can basically play with the synchronization how you want. It's very easy to take element one by one in one shot for all of them, and it's very flexible, we can say in a few words. After you decided what you do, you apply. Of course, you can save, as you see, a document about what information you changed. So it's up to you. Once you took the decision, these lines are disappearing from the dialogue, and it's resting just the rest of the objects, the one that you for which you didn't took a decision yet. So as you can see, we have some purlins which are bigger, and we can check live. So without closing the dialogue, we can check if it's what you expect it to do. So basically it's updating the sections that you, or the properties of the objects you changed. So for the rafters, as you can see, we have the new section. And if I go so everything is basically updated, what you accepted, what you ignored, it was ignored. Also, the materials, as you can see, is the same like what's in advanced steel. So it didn't change because you ignored that material. So you can do the same for all the elements. You can hide some, also it has other properties. So we can have different columns with materials that you have in the application, host application, in the GT6 file. Type, it means the section. So you have what information we have in the GT6 file, what information we have in the host application. So also here you can control the columns inside this dialog. You can get reports. Of course, if you want, if you use this mechanism in another application, you can import frame results. So basically, it's very easy and very it's a clean process, we can say, very user friendly, with all the details that you can control inside this this dialog. And of course, once you finished your synchronization, you can go further with advanced still and detail your structure, creating views, creating details, detailing drawings for your main parts, and also 3D views for the connections, and also detailing drawing for connection and so on, BOM, all the information, NC files for fabrication, and many others. Okay, this was the demo. Now we can have some conclusions about this presentation. The integration between advanced steel, Autodesk and Graitec Advance Design is getting stronger with every new version, thanks to the new synchronization mechanism. Because why we are saying that? You can control basically any detail of the synchronization process. You can see in detail the entire parameter hierarchy of each object. So you can know what object you are changing, what is the position of the object. It's a purl, it's a rafter. It depends the accuracy of the information you specified in your model, of course. See exactly what parameters are different. So we can see that it's a material, it's a section, it's a geometry point. And for each of them, you can take different decision of the parameters for just one single object. So if you want to keep all the material, but you want to ignore the you want to keep the section or the geometry, and you want to accept a new section, you can do that for one object. So you can control every parameter independently. You can see for both the host and the synchronization file the value of the parameters. So you can know what is inside Advanced Steel, and you know what is coming from Advanced Design. That allows you to compare and take a real decision. We have advanced filters inside this this dialog, and this mechanism is allowing you to basically filter and to do multiple filter. You can search filters, and it's easy for you to search the objects inside the file. You can select all, you can select several objects or several parameters. So it depends on you how you want to work. It's very adaptive to your workflow. So in the end, you are doing synchronization step by step. Once you take a decision, you can apply it. Then you take another decision, you can apply it. You can check the information inside your model to see if it's updated in real time. You don't need to close the dialog. So it's a synchronization step by step. You can bring FEM results with this depending on the platform you are using, because this mechanism that you see saw today here, it's available also in Advanced Design. It's available also in Revit from our power pack for Revit. This is all from my side. Thank you for attending, and if you have any questions, I will try to answer them. If I don't have time, you can contact me or I can come back to you via the application form that you selected inside the information that you gave when you registered to the webinar. Okay. Thank you for joining me, and I hope that you enjoyed all the webinars available presented to you during this week. Well, let me see. I have a question. Thanks. Pavel asked me if I'm telling you about 22 version of, well, I told you something new about 22 version of the power pack for Advanced Steel, which is coming with the synchronization mechanism. In fact, the synchronization mechanism will be available exactly the same how you saw it today in Advanced Design. So it's a very powerful mechanism threaded in now on all our platforms. Okay. Thank you all. I don't have any other question. I hope you have a great weekend, and until next time.